I was born in 1912 in Mount Calvary, Wisconsin. I had planned my escape when I found out where I was. There were five girls ahead of me in the family, and they had the rest of the instruments. And by the time there was a sixth one added to the drum, to the family orchestra, my dad decided it should be a drum, which was great for me, because what better instrument to play than the drums? We're practicing a lot. It's all practice in my childhood. We had time to play, have fun, but mainly, for instance, every school vacation we practiced 2 hours a day on piano, or our instrument by that time. Dad always said we cannot waste children's energies on anything but music, music, music. That's all he believed in, which was fortunate for us. We were very happy to hear that.
The way we swing the band.
We had a friend who was a professional drummer, and he got me started. I didn't immediately study. He got me started. I took drum lessons from various pit band drummers. So finally, later in my career, I started studying. In fact, Billy Ed Gladstone from Radio City Music Hall, considered the best drummer in America, came to me. He saw me play somewhere, and he asked me to come by backstage at Radio City Music Hall where he was playing. And he said, hey, I want to show you something. And then he wanted to show me his drum he had just made. And he said, I'm going to make you one. You know, I was just flabbergasted. He finally made drums for about seven other top drummers in the country. So I was lucky enough to get in on that. Finally took lessons from the best, fortunately, Billy Gladstone. Well, I liked it, but I don't know whether he liked it. I talked to him, but he didn't mention it, and I didn't mention it. It was not my idea, but he knew that. He knew I would go around saying, here I'm the female Jeep Cool. Well, when they'd write about me, they'd say this, and I had no control over it. I didn't mind. Well, I was always studying. I had a scholarship to Schoolyard, to Juilliard. Oh. So I was there for one summer, on the scholarship, and I was playing timpani there, and I studied with Ed Fisher, considered one of the top drummers, and then also with the NBC Orchestra, Kyle Glassman. I studied with him, also timpanist. We traveled with the family orchestra, and then as the older ones married and dropped out, and one went back to school, and two of us were left, organized the Coquettes Orchestra, traveled for about 4 years. And by that time, my sister got married. She and I were the only ones in the Coquettes. When she married, I decided I wanted to get off the road. I was tired of traveling. So I went to New York then to get my union card. And I had been engaged to get married with he was gone for 3 years. But in the excitement of going overseas, I think that's what led to the thing of marriage, you know. Oh, we could get married, you know, before you go away. And we couldn't. He was whisked away overnight before we expected him to go. We had planned to get married before he'd go. But all of a sudden, he was gone. Happened to all the girls. Yeah, that was really something. But it was exciting to be in New York at that time. Streets were full of sailors and servicemen. And 52nd Street was Swing Street, where these big bands had lost their musicians, and they brought it down to a few musicians. Benny Goodman was on the street with a few musicians, Artie Shaw, and Billie Holiday. One night, you know, I was on the street too, working, and on that street, all of the people on the street would go in between their half-hour intermissions. They would go and visit the next door neighbor. They were all within the three blocks. All these little clubs with these big bands playing with their little groups. All reduced little groups because the boys, they had lost their musicians. And then one night we were at Billie Holiday's, where she was singing. The place was jammed. Every place was always jammed. So they put up a tablecloth over it, and then two chairs, little chairs. And they brought this up right up to the stage, right smack against the stage, right under Billie Holiday, standing there. And her dress kept going into my hair, a well-coiffed hair. I didn't like it at all. And her dress, fluffy chiffon, was all over me because I was right smack against the stage. And straight up, I had to look to see Billie. I mean, right a little bit to my left because my stage was right in there. But that's how crowded the places were. They were all that jam, just jam. People were sitting on top of each other. She was amazing. Oh, what a beautiful voice. The girl bands didn't really come into their own until all the boys were going off to sea, into overseas. And then, of course, there were so many openings. You know, any girl musician who wanted a job could have one. So that's about the time I wrote this article. And the girls were getting the jobs, and right and left. Wonderful for the musicians. I mentioned so many musicians that were so great. And they many of them called me and were happy that to be reminded of them being available. They were all more or less available. They were doing what they call gigs, but they would be very happy to join big names rather than just an ordinary orchestra.
Their band and glee club are preparing some Between the Halves entertainment. So let's switch down to our floor microphone.
It was exciting to be making a picture in Hollywood. It was the first picture made of two. And they were, of course, always cracking up, and it was always, everybody was laughing all the time backstage. And every time somebody else was doing something, we'd sit around and watch the takes being taken, you know, watch the whole proceedings. Yeah, it was fun. It was really fun.
My, what's the matter with you?
And we traveled with the Major Bo show, that gong show. It was on television, and that show was on every Sunday. And the winner of the amateur, it was an amateur contest. And the winner would join us on the road, traveling week stands in the theaters. And then the winner of the Sunday program would join us for the headline of the show. And Sinatra used to be one before I ever got in with Major Bowes. Sinatra had been one of the winners in the previous year. So there were big names, and eventually they came out of our show. We were with them for 1 year. That was quite a thrill because they had four orchestras all together. They had Count Basie, Duke Ellington, Phil Spitalny, and Benny Goodman, yeah. So we had a revolving stage, huge auditorium in Washington, and Truman and his wife were sitting in the balcony, front seat of the balcony, and there was a huge auditorium filled with people. And then later on there was dancing with the orchestras. And so that was quite an exciting evening. And we were the Cabaret Kit Kat Band. We were on the stage quite a bit, on the platform, the Kit Kat Band. And every time they had a scene in the nightclub, we would come on with our little dolly, and then moved around to where we were in the nightclub. But one time it bumped into something. Stagehand wasn't doing his job, and we bumped into something. We all flew off the platform. Quite a picture for everybody. It was a better show than seeing us play, to see us sprawled around on the stage. Well, I'll tell you, the highlight of my life in music was the cabaret show on Broadway. That was very exciting because they had lights all around the stage, everywhere was lights going out toward the audience, amber lights. And we could see for about 20 rows, could see everybody in the theater. Well, every night we saw stars, every night. Bob Crosby and Miss Loretta Young sitting right in the first row. And, well, I can't start telling you. Everybody from Hollywood eventually saw the show, so we were told. when they come to New York. They all come to New York sooner or later. But all through the show, every night we'd see so many stars. And that was interesting because we weren't playing all the time on the stage. We'd be sitting in this nightclub on the stage and sort of look around who else is out there. So it really was the highlight of my life, really. And I worked like 5 shows a day at New York's Paramount Theater. That went on for 2 months, 7 days a week, 5 shows a day. And then on top of that, my dad died. At the same time, my fiancé was taken overseas, all on the same day, June 6th, 1942. All that happened at the same day. My fiancé going, dad dying, and I told one of the girls not to tell me when he died, to keep it, not, so nobody in the orchestra knew I knew. Because then I couldn't have done it, because I played the 5 shows that day. I couldn't have done it if I had felt sympathy. This way, if I pretended not to know, I could do it. But when I was ready for my drum solo, I was sitting on the stage, ready to play my drum solo, and then I didn't know what was happening. I was just sitting there and looking. And I didn't know I had more or less fainted before the drum solo. And then Spitali must have waved over to the tuba player next to me to come over and shake me. Because you had made the announcement, and I was sitting there, and I didn't go into my drum solo. I had more or less fainted, but didn't fall over. I was sitting there, you know, in a daze, and she came over and shook me. She said, "Viola, Viola, your drum solo." And then I, boom, 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 boom. Then I started playing, you know, very fast. And my heart was always pounding fast when I was drumming. So luckily, I didn't keel over. Could have happened. So that was the only time I really had an after effect, you know, from problem like that. And that was a big problem in my life then, that particular day. But fortunately, that fact that nobody knew I knew made it much easier. It's all amazing to me what I see now on the internet, and because I didn't own one, and I was living in New York without the internet, and didn't go visiting people where they had access to it. We didn't bother to sit down and look at what's on the internet. So I was really, everything comes as a great surprise. Really fantastic. It's just, I'm really very thankful that I am accepted as a drummer, a girl drummer, you know. The one time, there was no such thing. One thing always led to another. It was all very easy, the transitions. There were no big deal that I had to worry about ever. Everything went very easily in my life. I really had a charmed life. Can't believe it. Unless people call drumming work. Then I had worked hard in my life.